Norga Apartment Hotel, they had called it then. It was nicely set back from the traffic in Kong Oscar's Gate, with St. Jacob's Cemetery as a buffer zone, lushly planted with linden, beech, and horse chestnut trees. The old man in the wheelchair, who the woman in reception had said would be so pleased to have a visitor, occupied a room on the 7th floor. He was asleep, with a blanket over his legs when I arrived, but the nurse who accompanied me went over and shook him.
"Hans Jacob, wake up! You got a visitor?"
"Eh? Who?" He raised his head and looked around. Catching sight of me, he gave a broad grin, as though I were one of his best friends from years back.
"He's a bit hard of hearing, but otherwise he's in fine fettle," the nurse said.
A small, dark-haired woman who, despite her unmistakable Bergen dialect, came from quite different latitudes than these. Hans Jacob Neumann had the appearance of a tame bird of prey, sitting in the wheelchair with a crooked back. His forehead was high and his pate bald, except for a transparent white wreath of hair growing untidily from the back, and, in the light from the west-facing window, forming a kind of halo around his head. Through the window, I could see the glass dome of the railway station, Bergen College of Art, which had taken over the handsome building that was formerly the old people's home on the corner of Kaigarten, and the frivolous Lisverket building with its Stalinist facade, which always made me want to sing the Beatles Back in the USSR. I walked over to him and held out a hand. "Hello, Herr Neumann." He shook hands.
"Yes, thank you, I'm fine. Are you the new priest?"
No, my name's Vayum. I'm a sort of detective."
"Mentally defective?"
"Detective.